The lives of these people are very precious to us. And if this board has any impact whatsoever, we felt that their loss of their lives had better make a difference.
We saw this piece of debris drop off. It looked to us like it impacted the orbiter on the left wing. Through analysis and through our ability to call back on our experience with tile, it was judged that that event did not represent a safety concern. We were not concerned with Columbia. We felt we had analyzed that, and we felt we understood it such that it was not a thermal concern to us, did not represent a control issue or a safety of flight issue. And I'm going to caution you that that is the case today. We have no information that would say that is not the case.
I would say there were two causes to the accident. The first cause was the foam. The second was the loss within NASA of its system of checks and balances.
We like to use the quote that the foam did it, the institution allowed it. And you can look at whether it's the foam application, foam falling off, the mission management team's conduct, to looking at what happens with a shuttle on orbit. You can look across any of those, and you can see where things that were unexpected became expected and then became accepted. Of course, the key one is the foam. Foam falling off of an external tank is unexpected. It's not supposed to happen. Well, it happened, so it came to be expected. And because it was expected, it came to be accepted, and it went on to kill the seven crew members plus the two helicopter crew members that were involved in the debris search. So nine people died because of that normalization of deviance.